Hi, in this tutorial I will show how you can use MQTT with LabVIEW. So MQTT is a communication protocol very popular in Internet of Things applications, and LabVIEW is a very popular graphical programming language. So here you see the contents of this tutorial. First, a short introduction to MQTT, then LabVIEW, and then how to use MQTT in LabVIEW. I will explore the LabVIEW MQTT toolkit from the LabVIEW open source project. And I will provide some practical LabVIEW examples where MQTT are used. So I will demonstrate a LabVIEW MQTT broker, a LabVIEW MQTT publisher, and then a LabVIEW MQTT subscriber. So first, a short introduction to MQTT. So MQTT is a communication protocol very popular in Internet of Things applications. You can find more information about MQTT and the MQTT protocol at this web page. And you can use and implement MQTT in all of the most popular programming environments like LabVIEW, Visual Studio, and C#, Python, etc. So the default port for the MQTT protocol is 1883 and 8883 for secured SSL/TSL communication. And also MQTT can be used for used on all popular platforms like Windows, macOS, Linux, the Arduino platform, and also on Raspberry Pi. And you can use existing APIs, which is typically used by most users, or you can implement and use the MQTT protocol from scratch, because MQTT is a quite simple protocol. So with some effort, you can create your own implementation of MQTT. But in this tutorial, I will focus on using existing toolkit from this LabVIEW open source project. And also we will focus on LabVIEW in this tutorial. In another I have made different tutorials on MQTT, and in other tutorials I go in depth of MQTT, and also in another tutorial I show how you can use MQTT with Python. But in this tutorial, LabVIEW will be in focus. So here is an overview of MQTT and how it works. So the heart of an MQTT system is a so-called MQTT broker. This is the server in the system. And then you have different MQTT clients. And some of the MQTT clients can publish data to the MQTT broker. For this example, this MQTT client published temperature value to the MQTT broker, and then we can have other MQTT clients that subscribe on this topic, this temperature topic. So our MQTT system consists of a MQTT broker, which is the heart of the solution, and then you can have multiple MQTT clients that can either be a publisher or subscribers, or of course you can also have MQTT clients that can both publish data and subscribe to data. So then let's summarize. MQTT have the following terms. So you have an MQTT broker, which is the heart or the server of the system, and then you have MQTT clients like MQTT publishers. And MQTT publishers are clients that write or publish data to the MQTT broker. And then you can have MQTT subscribers, and that are clients that read or subscribe to the data that are published to the MQTT broker. So the data within MQTT are published to so-called topics. And topics are made of one or more topic levels separated by a forward slash. So here you see an example. So this is a topic consisting of one, two, three subtopics. So then, for instance, sensor slash temperature /temperature1. And these topics are used to organize the data within MQTT. Note that the topics are case sensitive, so upper and lower cases are different. So here you see an example of how topics can be used to organize your data. So then you can have the main topic sensors, and then you can have subtopics site 1, site 2, and then for the subtopic site 1, then you can have subtopics under there called temperature, pressure, and the same for site 2, etc. And then the entire topic for, let's say, this one is then sensors, site 1, and pressure. So in this tutorial, we will use the LabVIEW graphical programming environment. So LabVIEW is a graphical programming language and graphical programming environment. So the vendor is National Instruments. And LabVIEW has powerful features for simulation, control, and dock applications. And here you see an example of a LabVIEW program. So basically, you program in a graphical way. So next, in order to use MQTT in LabVIEW, of course, as mentioned, you can create and implement the MQTT protocol from scratch, but that may demand some heavy work in order to implement such a protocol from scratch, even if the MQTT is a simple protocol. So the best option is to use MQTT library or MQTT toolkit that has been made already. So in this tutorial, I will use MQTT toolkit from the LabVIEW open source project. So in order to install this MQTT package or toolkit or whatever you call it, you just open from the LabVIEW programming environment, you go to Tools and the VI Package Manager, and then you just search for MQTT and then the necessary packages for creating MQTT brokers and MQTT clients pops up, and then you can install these packages by just click on the packages you want to install and then click on the install button. So how can we use this MQTT toolkit in LabVIEW? So here, when you have installed the necessary packages from the VI Package Manager, the following palette appears in the LabVIEW programming environment. So when you right-click in the block diagram in LabVIEW, select Add-ons and the LabVIEW Open Source Project, then this MQTT features pops up. So then here you see the main MQTT palette, where you have MQTT client server, which is the main palette. And then when you click on this palette, you can choose either to implement an MQTT broker or an MQTT client. First, typically need to create the MQTT broker. So either create an MQTT broker in LabVIEW, or of course you can also use an existing MQTT broker. There exist many free MQTT brokers that you can either install on your local computer or a server, or use within the cloud. But in order to create an MQTT broker within this toolkit, you just select the MQTT broker palette. Then you have the necessary sub-VIs, as it's called in LabVIEW, to create such an MQTT broker. So typically you need this sub-VI, create server, read server public events, and then start the server and stop and destroy the server. So when you have created the server or the MQTT broker, then you need to create one or more MQTT clients. So in this tutorial, we will create two MQTT clients. One client that are publishing data, and another client that are subscribing to data. So then you need to select this subpalette, MQTT client, and then this subpalette pops up, and then Typically, you need to use these sub-VIs, create MQTT client, read public events, connect to server, and this sub-VI that check if you are connected to the server or not. Then, either if you are going to publish data, you need to use this publish sub-VI, or if you are going to subscribe to data, you need to use one of these subscribe sub-VIs. And finally, you need to disconnect from the server using this sub-VI. Then let's take a closer look at some LabVIEW examples. So I will demonstrate three different applications. First, the first LabVIEW application, LabVIEW application number one, is an MQTT broker. And then LabVIEW application number two is an MQTT publisher. So this publisher application gets data from a temperature sensor and then publish the data to the broker. And then the broker is responsible for forwarding the data to the clients that subscribe on this given topic. So then the third application will be a LabVIEW MQTT subscriber application that are receiving data from the broker and plot the data in this example. So this application will subscribe on a given topic, and then when this publisher application publishes a new value to the broker, then the subscriber application will retrieve the latest value from the broker and then plot it within the application. So now I have opened my LabVIEW programming environment and opened the three applications. So here, this is the LabVIEW MQTT broker. Here is the LabVIEW MQTT publisher client. So this client reads temperature data from a given temperature sensor and then publish the value to this broker. And also it plots the values within this chart. And then the third application, the LabVIEW MQTT subscriber client, are subscribing on the same topic. This I have created a topic called sensor/temperature/temp1. And then this subscriber application subscribe to this the same topic. And then when a new value has been published from this publisher application via the MQTT broker, then this subscriber receive the latest value and then plot the new value within this chart. So basically, these are the three applications. I will dig into the details later, but first let's just demonstrate the three applications. So I will start by running the broker. This broker application is quite simple. It has a field for showing how many clients that are connected to the broker. And then let's start this LabVIEW MQTT publisher application. And now it starts to get values from this temperature sensor every fifth second. But this can be configured, so you can change the sampling time here. But now a new value are retrieved from the temperature sensor every fifth second. And so far it's only retrieving value from the temperature sensor and plot it. And by clicking on this connect button, it will connect to the broker. So still and there are zero connected clients. But when I click on this connect button, you see connected clients becomes one. And this means that the values are published to the broker in this case. And as you see here also in this status, data are published to the broker. And then this third application, the LabVIEW MQTT subscriber. Let's start this one also. So here you can select the topic which you should subscribe on, which is the same and the topic in the publisher application. And then you have connect, so now one clients are connected, this one, And when I click here and connect, then you see two clients are connected to the broker. So we have this client and this client, both are connected to the broker. But so far you don't see any data here in the chart. So you need to click here on the subscribe. And now you see this application publishes a new temperature value every 5 seconds, and then it publishes the value to the broker, and then the broker lets this application that subscribed on the same topic, let this application know that there has been a new value, and then the value are retrieved by this application and plotted in this chart. So basically, these are the three applications. So let's dig into the details. So now I will dig into the details how you create these three applications. So first, you need to install this MQTT toolkit. So you go to here in the LabVIEW programming environment, you go to Tools, VI Package Manager. If this VI Package Manager doesn't exist under your Tools menu, you just go to Internet in your web browser, Google VI Package Manager, and then you can install this application for free. And then it will, when you have installed it and restarted your LabVIEW software or your computer, and then it will pop up here under Tools. If it doesn't pop up here, you can also go to the Start menu in Windows and search for it, and then you can start it as a separate application. Basically, this VI Package Manager is an application that you can use in order to install additional LabVIEW packages. So then you just here in the search window search for MQTT, and the different packages appears. So typically you need to use the depending on what you are going to install, if you are going to develop an MQTT broker from scratch, you need this MQTT package. If you are going to create an MQTT client, you need this package. And typically, in order to make the client connect to the broker, you need also this MQTT connection package. And typically, the communication between the clients and the broker are using TCP, so you need this MQTT TCP connection, either this one or this secure TCP connection. So these are typically the packages you want to install. And then you just click on the packages and click on the install button here. And when these packages are installed, then you go back to your LabVIEW programming environment. Like this, and a LabVIEW program consists of a front panel and a block diagram. So the front panel are used to create the graphical interface, the graphical user interface, and then this block diagram are used to create the code. So then here in the block diagram, you just right click, and then under add-ons, you find this LabVIEW open source project, and then MQTT. So then you can pin this palette, and then you have these different sub palettes, and the main palette is this MQTT client server, where you have the necessary functions for creating an MQTT broker, which is here, and then creating a MQTT broker within this toolkit is quite easy. You only typically need this create server and this read server public events. While for creating an MQTT client, then you have more sub-VIs that you need to use. Typically, you need this create MQTT client, read public events, connect to server, and this disconnect from server, and then this publish, and you're going to publish data to the broker, or one of these subscribe sub-VIs if you are going to subscribe to a given topic. So you find the sub-VIs you need here, either if you're going to subscribe for a scalar data or an array. And also when you want to unscribe, you use this unscribe scalar and unscribe array. So basically these are the sub-VIs or the functions you need in order to create both MQTT broker and MQTT clients. So then let's start with the LabVIEW MQTT broker. So here is the front panel, which is quite easy. Just a box for seeing a number of connected clients. So let's go to the block diagram. So this is the MQTT broker. Here I am using a programming technique called state machine, which consists of a while loop. And inside the while loop, I'm using a case structure. And here on the end of the while loop, I'm using, just by right click here, I'm using something called shift registers. So these three here are called shift registers. These shift registers are used to transfer information between the different cases. So basically, creating a state machine like this consists of, so if I create this state machine, this consists of basically a while loop, and inside the while loop you create a case structure like this. So basically this is a state machine, and then typically you need to create here on the end of the while loop, create a shift register, and then since this is called a state machine, you need to create different states here within this case structure, and then the startup case can be entered here. It could be initialize like this, and then you just wire this to this this shift register, which you find here. When you right click on the border, add shift register like this, and then you can wire this output to this question mark like this, and then you need to create a state here called initialize like this, and then you can create some initialize code here, typically clear the data within a plot, start communication with the server or the client, etc. And then you typically need to go to another case. Typically you create a case called wait. And you can also right click here and then see the different cases. You can add case after, add case before, etc. So then this, so the first case is this initialize, and then you typically want to go to this wait case, and then you type the wait, have the wait case here, and typically within this wait case you create an event structure like this, and then typically on your front panel, your graphical user interface, you typically create a button. So let's just create a button called stop that are stopping the program, and then I can double click on it, and then this stop button pops up here. I can just put it there, and then I can right click on this event structure. I just also show the visible items here. So this is an event structure, this is a case structure, and this is a while loop. And then within this event structure, I can right click here on the border, add event case, and then I can select this stop button. Just click OK. So this means when the users click on this button, the application will go into this event called the stop button. And then typically we can create a new case called exit, like this. Then here, since the program are going to exit, you can just, it's not so important what you write here, you can just write wait, like this. And then you can also right click to rearrange the cases. So then this initialize is the first case, then wait, and then exit, like this. So now we have this initialize, then it goes to wait, and then when you click the stop button, you want the program to go to the exit case like this. Then we just wire exit to this shift register like this. And now we are almost finished. So the next thing we know, I need to do now, is to create, right click here, create a constant. So now here in this loop condition, the while loop will stop if this value gets true. So then we just here in initialize, we have this boolean constant to be false, and the same here in the wait case. And then finally, when it goes to exit, we set this boolean constant to be true like this. So now we can test this state machine. Just save it to the hard drive somewhere. Example. Just click OK, and now can go and run this application. So now the program is running, and now when you click on this stop button, the program stops. So basically, when we turn on this highlighting, so you see when we start this application, you see now we go to initialize, and then it goes to wait, and then it's just wait here until we click on this stop button. And then you see this event structure stop button goes here, and then it goes to the exit case. And then since this is true, the while loop stops and the program stops. So basically this is a state machine principle which you are using here in the examples. So then let's dig into some more details regarding this LabVIEW MQTT broker. So here is the front panel, and here is the block diagram, the code. So then, as you see here, I'm using this state machine with a while loop, case structure, and then also here in wait, this event structure. So let's start with the first case called initialization. So this is the startup case, and then inside here, not so much are done, only just set connected clients to zero. Because when we start the broker, there should be no connected clients. So then this and connected clients are just set to zero. And then the next case, initialize a broker. And then we go to this case, initialize broker. And then we just create the server and read server public events, and then start the broker. And also we need to use this configure TCP connection. And as mentioned earlier, this port for MQTT is 1883. And here you specify the address, typically the IP address. But since all my three applications are running on my local computer, I just type localhost. So this create server and this read server public events, you find it here in this MQTT broker palette. So this is this one. And read server public events are here. And this start VI is found here in this MQTT base, which you find here. And this configure TCP connection is found in the MQTT connection palette, TCP connection, and then this one, configure TCP connection. And the input to this one is, as mentioned, this IP address and the port number. this is the code, necessary code, in order to create an MQTT client within this MQTT toolkit. Then next we go to wait, which is here, and then we have this event structure. The first event is called timeout. This means this event structure goes into this event when nothing happens here on the front panel. And then you typically adjust, if there are some error messages in the system, I just present these error messages here in a text box, and then nothing else. And then it's just the program goes here and wait for something to happen. So the next event is an event, an MQTT event called number of connections. So if some other MQTT clients are connecting to the MQTT broker, then these events occur, and then here in this property you can find number of connections, and then number of connections are just written here in this numeric indicator. And then here also there's an exit button, so when I want to close this LabVIEW MQTT broker, I just click on this exit button, and then I have an event called exit button. And also here is no code, only goes to the next case called exit, which you find here. And then I just unregister for these events, stop the broker, and destroy the broker like this. And this stop and destroy, you find it here under MQTT base. So stop and destroy here. So basically, this is the LabVIEW MQTT broker. So next, let's dig into this LabVIEW MQTT publisher client application. So let's start with the front panel. Here, there's a text box which you find here. So string, this is a string control where you enter the topic, which is in this example sensors / temperature / temp1, and then you specify the sampling time, which is just a numeric control which you find here. And then here is a chart for showing the current temperature and the historic temperature in a chart. So the chart is found here in graph on this waveform chart. Also, you can see the current temperature here in just this numeric indicator field, which you find here. And then you have two buttons, one exit button. The buttons are found here. And here you have the stop button. And I have used the stop button and just changed it to exit. And then you have this button, connect. And then I have just chosen to use one of these pre-made buttons, which you find here. And then just change the name for it. So that's the front panel or the graphical user interface. Then let's go to the block diagram. Also here, this application is created using this state machine principle. So we have this while loop and this case structure within the while loop. And then we have this initialization case. And in this case, I just clear this chart for old values like this. I also set this connection button and the other buttons and set them to false. And also this temperature value, I just set not a number here, because in the beginning, before we start logging data, the temperature is just set to not a number. So that's the initialization case. Then next case, initialize MQTT, which is this case. So here we create this MQTT subscriber client by using this configure TCP connection, which you found here under MQTT connection, TCP connection, and this configure TCP connection. And also here we use the localhost and the port 1883, and then create MQTT client, which you find here, MQTT client MQTT client. So this one, create MQTT client, and this read public events, which you find here, and then start, which you find in this MQTT base palette here, this start. So these are functions or subways you need in order to create an MQTT client. And then next we go to the wait case, and the wait case is an event structure with different events. The first event is this timeout, and then since this application are retrieving data from a temperature sensor every sampling time, which you can configure here, then I'm using this elapsed time function, which you find here under timing, elapsed time, which is this one. Then you just wire the sampling time as an input to the time target, and then when in this case 5 seconds has been reached, then it goes to another case called temperature data. So let's open this temperature data case, and here in this basic example I'm not retrieving temperature data from a real temperature sensor, I'm just using the built-in random generator in LabVIEW. So this generator in this case generates a random temperature data between 20 and 30 degrees Celsius and then present it within this chart and in this numeric indicator. So when we have retrieved this temperature data from this simulated temperature sensor, it goes to the next case called publish data, which is this case. And then here we check, start to check if we are connected to the broker or not. And if you are connected, not connected to the broker, we typically do nothing. And if you are connected to the broker, we publish this temperature value to the broker for this specific topic. So then we use this publish function, which you find here under MQTT client, and publish. But so far we are not connected to the broker yet, so then let's go back to this wait function. Then we have an event here called connection button, which you see on the front panel. So we are not connected to the broker before we click on this connect button. And then when we click on this connect button, then we go into this event called connection button value change. And then inside here, if connection button is set to true, if you click on this button, then we connect to the server or to the broker using this connect to server, which you find here, connect to server. And then when you click on this button, change to disconnect. And then if you click once more in order to disconnect, then this connection button changes from true to false, and then the code goes into here, disconnect from server, which you find here. So this is the disconnect from server sub-VI that are used here. So basically when we either connect or disconnect, it goes into this this event within this state machine. So now that we are when we click this connect button, now we are connected to the server, and then next time 5 seconds, which is a sampling time, this elapsed time function reaches 5 seconds, it goes to temperature data, which was this one, find a new temperature value using this random generator, then goes to publish data. And now we are connected to the server, so this output here is connected, is true, so then it goes into this part of the program and publishes the data to the broker. So basically, let's start this MQTT broker and the MQTT publish a client. Now, now just read or generate a new temperature data every 5 seconds. So it goes into wait, check if 5 seconds has elapsed, then it goes to temperature data, create and generate a new temperature data and show it here in the plot, goes to publish data. So far we haven't connected to the broker, so it goes into here and do nothing. And then we click on the connect here, and then you see on the broker 1 clients are connected, and then it goes into wait here and this connected button event. And then since this connected button has been true, it connects to the server. And when the server is connected, when the client are connected to the server, this published data and is connected is true, and then it publishes a new updated temperature value every 5 seconds until we click on this disconnect. And then the application goes into wait and connection button is false, and then it disconnects from the server. And finally, when we click on the exit button, it goes into the exit button event, which goes to the exit case, which is here. And then we just stop and destroy the connection to the broker. So basically, this is the LabVIEW MQTT publisher client. Then next, let's dig into the, this third application, LabVIEW MQTT subscriber client. So this front panel is almost identical as this other client. Here you specify the topic, here you see the temperature value, and here you also plot the temperature value, but now the values here are not retrieved from a simulated temperature sensor, it are retrieved from the broker. So then we have a connect button in order to connect to the broker, and then a subscribe button in order to subscribe on this specific topic. And then a new value or a data for this specific topic has reached the broker, then this subscriber client are notified, and then a new data point are plotted here in this this chart. And also finally, you can click here on the exit button in order to stop the application. So that's the front panel or the graphical user interface. Then let's dig into the block diagram. And then also here we use the state machine principle, where we have a while loop, a case structure, and here on the border we have these shift registers. Then we have also here a case called initialization. It just configure the chart, clear all the values, etc., and set these buttons through to false when the program starts. So next case here is initialize MQTT as in the previous application. Then we have the same here. We create the MQTT client in the same way. Use this configure TCP connection, create MQTT client, and read public events, and then start. And then we go to the wait, which you find here. And then we have the first event for this connect button. So when we click on the connect, this button goes to true and shows disconnect instead. Then this here in this event handler, it goes into this event called connection button, and then this button goes to true. Here it's true, so then it connects to the server, and if you click it once more, the button value is false, and then it disconnects from the server. So that's this connect button, and next is this subscribe button, which you find here. So when you click on the subscribe button, So when you click on the subscribe button, we first check if you are connected to the broker or not, which is done by when you click on this connect button. So if you are connected to the broker, then it goes into true, and then if the subscribe button is true, then you start subscribing to the specific topic, which you find here. So this is the topic. And when you unscribe, click on this button, then it goes, then this subscribe button is false, and then you unscribe to the topic. And this subscribe button and the unscribe functions are found here in the MQTT client palette. So here you have the subscribe and the unscribe functions. Then next we have the most important event here is this this one. Client public events dot application message user event. So this is event that occur when a new value are published to the MQTT broker. So here in the initialized MQTT, we start listening to this event from the MQTT broker, and when a new value has been published to the MQTT broker, this event occurs. So this in order to create this event, we need to right click here on the border of the event structure, and then select show dynamic event terminals, and then this small icon appears, and then we need to here in the where we are initializing the events, this goes to this shift register here, and then this output of this shift register are connected to this event dynamic registration. And then we have when we have done that, we can right click here, add event case, and then under dynamic events we can select the proper events, which you find here, here, and then you need to select the proper event, which is in this case this client public events dot application message, like this. And inside here we create the necessary code in order to retrieve the new published value to the broker and retrieve it to this client. So then first we use this get topic name to make sure that the topic that are now received from the broker is the same as the topic we are subscribing on. So we just check that the topic that are now received from the server are the same as the topic we have selected here. And if it's the same, then the code goes into this true case. So this is case structure. And then it starts to decode the message we receive from the broker. And since we are only receiving a basic numeric value, a double, then we need to specify the data type here, which is just a double. So we just create this double numeric constant, which you find here, as an input to this this type. And then we need to use this variant to data that transforms this general data structure that we receive from the broker into a numeric data type. And then the output of this variant to data is just this numeric temperature value, and also it it are shown here in this numeric indicator, and it also plotted here in the chart. So basically, these are the three applications. So let's just start it, these three applications once more. We have the LabVIEW MQTT broker, we have the LabVIEW MQTT publisher client, and then we have, finally, we have this LabVIEW MQTT subscriber. So now we have zero connected clients, then we connect this publisher that are generating random simulated temperature data and publish it to the broker. And then in this LabVIEW MQTT subscriber client, we connect to the broker, and now you see we have two connected clients, and then we start subscribing on this specific topic. And then when a new value or data point on this specific topic are published to the broker, then this client received a new event and receives this updated temperature value from the broker. So basically, this is how we can implement and create MQTT applications within the LabVIEW programming environment. So let's summarize. In this tutorial, we have given a short introduction to MQTT in general. We have explored this LabVIEW MQTT toolkit from the LabVIEW open source project. We have demonstrated some practical LabVIEW MQTT examples. We have demonstrated a LabVIEW MQTT broker and a LabVIEW MQTT publisher and a LabVIEW MQTT subscriber. So the next step would be to explore and test if this LabVIEW MQTT toolkit can connect to other different free MQTT brokers like the Eclipse Mosquito MQTT broker, the Hive MQTT Community Edition broker, or the cloud version, this Hive MQTT Cloud, ThingSpeak, etc. And it would also be interested to see if we can use another MQTT client like this MQTTX to connect to this LabVIEW MQTT broker. But these steps are not part of this tutorial. So basically, that's all for now. So good luck with your LabVIEW programming and the MQTT applications. Thank you.